This is Dr. Vani, and I welcome you on behalf of Vedanta to another super cool, super fun, and super amazing session, which we are going to take right here and right now. Yes, my dear children. So what you see right now in front of you is a child opening a window, and through that window, what is coming in? Through that window are coming in stars, are coming in, you know, merriment, fulfillment, a life full of success. So my dear, dear children, this is what you're doing right now. You're opening that very window, which will remain open for the next 40, 50 years of your life. And how do you open this window? You open this window with your hard work. That is all this window of success demands from you. This window of success, through which all great things will walk into your life, demands that at this junction in your life, you put in a lot of hard work. Those of you who shall not put in hard work, for them, this window of success shall never ever open. So it depends only on you whether you want to open this window of success or not. And to open the window of success, I want you to promise me one thing today. Is that clear? What do you have to promise to me? You have to promise that you will work very, very, very hard. That you will work so hard that you make your parents very proud. Yes, that you work so hard that you make your younger brothers and sisters extremely proud, right? That you motivate them. You work so hard that you make sure your entire community, your town, the place where you live, becomes extremely proud of you. This country and all of us together become proud of you. That is how hard you have to work. So you've got to promise me that you will waste no time. You will study really, really hard. You will not entertain any negativity. Yes, you will not get scared. You will not let fear come in. You will not waste any moment, any time, any second thinking about negative things. Is that clear? And is that a promise that is made by each one of you to me in today's class? Yes, that's a deal that you all give me. Perfect. So let's move ahead. This is your table night now. Yes, all the midnight oil that you are burning, my dear children, will make sure that you take center stage in life. Yes, your study lamp will give you light to become, yes, famous in your entire life. So you have to make sure that you right now study very, very, very hard. And the most important thing is, while studying hard, you stay very, very calm. You stay focused and you stay calm. Yes. So is that happening? Are you all making that promise to me? Are you all going to make sure that you study well late into the night? Yes. Along with that, you make sure that you also stay calm. Yes, you all will stay calm. Correct. Chaliye. So with that, let's start another super cool, super amazing and amazing, amazing session today on part one, that is human health. On human health, also in the next few days, I'm going to be discussing a lot, many subparts. So this is part one. This is one of the most important topics of class 12. 18 to 16 marks can come from this singular most important topic. Apart from the topic, you will see in today's class, I am going to do a lot of theory. As I always tell you, a lot of extra theory will be discussed per question in the class. So make sure that you sit with your papers and pens ready. Done. So without any delay, let me come to question number one. A lot of extra theory gets discussed. It's a very important topic from NCERT point of view. Extremely, extremely, extremely important. You've made a promise to me that you will not entertain negativity. You will stay very positive. You will work very hard. You will make your entire community extremely proud of who you are. Yes. So with that, on your screen, question number one, here it is. A person is likely to develop tetanus. So there's a person who comes to your clinic. Assume you are a doctor. So there's a person who's coming to your clinic. He is likely to develop tetanus. You immunize him. You protect him. You immunize him by giving what? Tetanus, extra information, pay attention, write it down, is caused by a bacteria by the name of Clostridium tetani. So there is a name of a bacteria by the name of Clostridium tetani, which causes tetanus. Point number one on your copy, can come in the exams. This Clostridium tetani produces something which is called a neurotoxin. Which toxin? It produces something which is called as a, yes, as a neurotoxin. This neurotoxin will paralyze the patient, right? Therefore, it is a very dangerous and a critical disease. Right now, pay attention to what I'm saying. This is very, very important. I'm giving you a lot of extra information. Please pay attention. Listen to me. Now, a person is likely to develop tetanus. That means that person is infected. इसीलिए उसको टेटनस होने का चांस है. वो इन्फेक्ट हो गया. कैसे इन्फेक्ट हुआ होगा? वो इन्फेक्ट हुआ होगा अगर उसको किसी रस्टी या किसी मडी जगह से चोट लग गई होगी. राइट, बिकॉज क्लॉस्ट्रिडियम टेटनस इज अ वेरी कॉमन सॉयल बैक्टीरिया. बहुत कॉमन सॉयल बैक्टीरिया है. इज दैट क्लियर? राइट, सो हो सकता है उसको किसी मिट्टी वाली जगह या रस्ट वाली जगह से चोट लग गई हो, तो वो इन्फेक्ट हो गया है. अब ये जो टेटनस है, ये टेटनस का जो बैक्टीरिया है, अगर ये बॉडी में एंटर कर गया है, तो ये क्या बनाएगा? ये बनाएगा टॉक्सिन्स. एंड दीज टॉक्सिन्स आर न्यूरोटॉक्सिन, सो ये जाकर पैरालाइज कर सकती है. तो आपको इन टॉक्सिन्स को रोकना है. हाउ विल यू स्टॉप द टॉक्सिन्स? बाय मेकिंग एंटीबॉडीज अगेंस्ट देम. यस, इनके खिलाफ आप बॉडी में एंटीबॉडीज डाल दोगे. अगर इस स्टेज पे आप वैक्सीन दोगे, भले ही वो डेड जर्म्स हो, वीक जर्म्स हो, पर इस स्टेज पे अगर आप वैक्सीन दोगे, वो आदमी इन्फेक्ट हो चुका है. तो अगर इस स्टेज पे आप वैक्सीन दोगे, काम नहीं करेगा. सो यू हैव टू गिव एंटीबॉडीज. ये एंटीबॉडीज हम लैब में पहले से बनाकर रखते हैं और जब ऐसा कोई पेशेंट आता है उसको दे देते हैं. दे आर नोन एज प्रीफॉर्म्ड, पहले से बनाकर रखा गया है. जब हमारे पास बायोटेक्नोलॉजी नहीं थी और हमारे पास एंटीबॉडीज बनाने का कोई साधन नहीं था, एक्स्ट्रा इंफॉर्मेशन थ्योरी, pay attention, that time we used to take the antibodies by infecting horses. So they were known as horse anti-tetanus serum, horse ATS. Very, very important. So a person likely to develop tetanus is immunized by administering preformed antibodies. Preformed antibodies are made earlier. They are not made at the last moment. They are already made and kept. So they are made earlier. Understood in the laboratory by using biotechnology. Look at the theory. This is how a Clostridium tetani looks. It's a bacillus. It's a rod-shaped bacteria. Tetanus is a very serious infection of the nervous system. I've told you this can come in the MCQ. I've told you it causes paralysis. It produces neurotoxin. So it's a disease of the nervous system. Right, neurotoxin can come in MCQ. It's a gram positive bacteria. It's a rod shaped bacteria. I've shown you. It's an anaerobic bacteria, lives without oxygen, can come in an MCQ. Right, so it affects skeletal muscles. Skeletal muscles ko move karne nahi deta hai. That is paralysis. It's very fatal. We produce antitoxin or antibodies initially. Hum banakar lab mein rakh lete hai. Any doubts? Should I say, is that clear? Any doubts, anything that you've not understood, is that clear? Moving ahead to the next question. Yes, this is a very, very, very important topic. Next question on your screen. Antihistamines, right? This is a very, very common. You must have taken a drug sometimes when you have cold by the name of, you know, Allegra, right? Right, everybody? So, antihistaminics and steroids kab diye jate hain for quick relief for what? Do we give antihistaminics and steroids? Is it for nausea or vomiting? Is it for cough? Is it for a headache or is it for an allergy? Right? What is it for? It is obviously for a allergy. See, I take pepper, right? Imagine I've taken pepper. Imagine. And I take this pepper and I blow it on your face. So will you start to sneeze? Right, everybody? Yes. If there is dust in a room and you're walking, do you all start to again sneeze? Will there be water which will come out from your eyes? Yes. Or, you know, your nose, there will be some mucus. This is all plasma which comes out. Is that clear? The fluid which comes out when you sneeze from the eyes, from the nose, it is tear, it is mucus. Right, this is all forms of plasma which come out. So antihistaminic kya hota hai? Histamine causes vasodilation. Ye blood vessel hai, हिस्टमीन क्या करेगा, इस ब्लड वेसल को ओपन कर देगा. लुक एट द अमाउंट ऑफ थ्योरी दैट आई एम डूइंग, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ब्लड वेसल को ओपन करना कहलाता है वेसो डायलेशन. सो हिस्टमीन वेसो डायलेट कर देता है, इट ओपन्स द ब्लड वेसल्स बिकॉज ऑफ विच द फ्लूइड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्लाज्मा कम्स आउट. द फ्लूइड कम्स आउट, दैट इज नोन एज वेसो डायलेशन, राइट? सो दिस इज द फंक्शन ऑफ हिस्टमीन. एक्स्ट्रा इन्फॉर्मेशन, आई एम मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड टू गिव यू एक्स्ट्रा इन्फॉर्मेशन, प्लीज पे अटेंशन. देयर इज अ सेल इन द बॉडी, दैट सेल इज नोन एज अ प्लाज्मा cell, very important. It's known as a plasma cell, also known as aka, it's also known as a basophil. The basophil or the plasma cell has got granules. What does it have? Granules. So whenever there is an allergic response in the body, extra information, please pay attention. So whenever there is an allergic response in the human body, this they come out. Now what do these granules contain? One granule, one, two and three, let's put it like that. What do the granules contain? Number one, they contain histamine. What does the histamine do? The histamine does something which is called a vasodilation, where it will open the blood vessels so that the extra fluid can come out. Dekho bachcho, why should the fluid come out? Why? Why should the fluid come out? Now, any foreign substance has entered the body. Imagine a dust particle has entered the body. So it's a foreign substance. So this fluid which is coming out from the blood vessel will try to throw the foreign substance out. Is that clear? Jo bhi cheez body mein enter kar rahi hai, whatever is the foreign substance which is entering, it's going to try and throw it out. Is that clear? Histamine. Second is serotonin. अब ब्लड वेसल एक बार ओपन हो गया है तो ब्लड वेसल क्लोज भी तो होगा, ओपन थोड़ा ना रहेगा. क्लोज को हम कहते हैं कंस्ट्रिक्शन. सो कंस्ट्रिक्शन कौन करेगा? सर्टोनिन. एंड फाइनली, सो हिस्टामिन, सर्टोनिन एंड फाइनली व्हाट इज देयर? वन इज हिस्टामिन, सेकंड इज सर्टोनिन, फाइनली क्या है? फाइनली व्हाट इज देयर? यस, हेपेरिन. हेपेरिन इज अ एंटी कोएगुलेंट, राइट? सो दीज आर द थ्री फंक्शंस. सो हिस्टामिन बॉडी सिक्रीट करती है जब एलर्जी होती है. तो एंटी हिस्टामिनिक्स कब हमें लेनी पड़ेंगी? वो एलर्जी रिस्पॉन्स को जब हमें कम करना है. स्टीरॉइड्स आर ऑल्सो एंटी, मींस अगेंस्ट इंफ्लेमेटरी, राइट? सो दे आर एंटी इंफ्लेमेटरी. सो इन एलर्जी योर बॉडी इज शोइंग लीकीनेस, देयर विल बी फ्लूइड कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम द आईज, फ्लूइड कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम द नोज, फ्लूइड कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम द माउथ. सो एंटी हिस्टामिनिक्स विल डिक्रीज दिस फ्लूइड. वेयर इज द हिस्टामिन कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम? द हिस्टामिन कम्स आउट फ्रॉम द बेसोफिल और द प्लाज्मा सेल. आई हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस क्वेश्चन in detail. If you don't understand, please feel free to get back in touch with me. Yes, so see this allergic response, see this allergic response, so much of swelling, right? So much of fluid. So you will have to take antihistamines. So antihistamines work by preventing histamines from attaching to certain sites on cells and causing allergic reactions. Which one of the following is a pair of viral disease? Viral, come on. Come on your screen. Question number A, B, C, D. Options. Simple question. Yes. Yes, you're right. Which one of the following? Common cold. Common cold is caused by para-influenza virus. Right? Influenza virus. There are so many viruses which can cause it. And this is also caused by HIV virus. Dysentery can be caused by Salmonella typhi. Can be caused by Vibrio cholera. So it's not. Typhoid is a bacteria, Salmonella typhi, Mycobacterium tuberculum, again bacteria. Ringworm is caused by fungus, right? Bacteria, bacteria, bacteria. So the answer will be option number one. Common cold is a viral disease. It is caused by mixovirus, influenza, influenza virus, para-influenza virus, H influenza virus. It causes fever, pain, yes, body aches, malaise. AIDS is caused by HIV virus. So both of them are caused by virus. Is that clear? There is another form of sore throat. Please pay attention. There is a special form of sore throat known as streptococcal sore throat. This is caused by bacteria. Right? This is a special form which is caused by bacteria. I remember मैंने एक बार पहले क्लास ली थी तो मुझे इतने मैसेजेस आए थे कि मैम स्ट्रेप सोर थ्रोट इज कॉज्ड बाय वायरस. यू आर राइट, दिस इज अ वायरस, बट देयर इज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ सोर थ्रोट कॉल्ड अ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकल सोर थ्रोट व्हिच इज कॉज्ड बाय अ बैक्टीरिया, राइट? शुड आई मूव अहेड? एनी डाउट्स टिल नाउ? Any doubts? Ringworm. Ringworm is a misnomer. What do you understand by misnomer? That means it's wrongly named. It's not caused by any worm. There is no Tinea solium roundworm, nothing which causes it. It's caused by a fungus by the name of Microsporum, right? There are so many funguses which cause it. I have written all of them in detail. Not caused by bacteria, not caused by a nematode, not caused by a virus. It is in fact caused by a fungus. The fungus is also called as, yes, you are right, dermatophytosis, because the derma stands for skin. It's a fungal disease of the skin. Therefore, it is known as dermatophytosis. Is that clear? Are you understanding everything? Yes, this is a very, very important chapter. So you have to make sure that your attention is right here in the class. Ringworm or tinea is a fungal infection of the skin. Scalp, that means the head or even the nails. Ringworm is caused by dermatophyte fungus. Dermatophyte is anything which lives on the skin. It spreads by a species of Microsporum. Trichophoton, trica means hair-like. So if it's close to the scalp, close to the hair, epidermophyton is of the top layer of the skin. It can spread by direct contact. That means suppose somebody has a fungal infection, they've used a comb to brush the hair, you use the same one. Or somebody has a fungal infection, you use their towel or you shake hands with them, right? And they have fungal infection here, it can spread. So direct contact or by infected materials like sharing clothes, right? And why is it called ringworm? Because the lesions or jo injury hoti hai, chot hoti hai, it could look like partial or complete rings. It's treated by antifungal agents like nystatin B. Right? Everybody, is that clear? So ringworm is a fungal disease. Any doubts on this? Cool. Select the correct statement from the ones given below. There are four statements which are given below. You've got to select a correct statement for me. Come on. Come on, fast. Barbiturates, when given to criminals, make them tell the truth. Is it? Morphine is often given as a painkiller. Chewing tobacco lowers blood pressure and heart rate. It's absolutely wrong. It increases. I'm going to give you only one hint per question. Yes, cocaine is given to patients after surgery as it stimulates recovery. So what is the correct answer? Yes, morphine, which is taken out from the plant, which is an opium. So it is opioid analgesic. Analgesic means painkiller. It is opium. It is also used as a drug. It is analgesic. It's analgesic of the opioid family. So it's referred to as opioid analgesic. It is taken out from the plant by the name of Papaver somniferum, which is nothing but poppy. So you take it out from a plant by the name of Papaver somniferum. It could come as an MCQ question, Papaver somniferum. It is given as a painkiller, especially after majors. Why? Anybody? Why? Because it goes to the central nervous system. Is that clear? It goes to the, see, all your other painkillers which you normally take, any of your paracetamols, your brufens, they remain in the peripheral nervous system. That is why they are not very strong. But morphine goes to the central nervous system. This could be a AIIMS question. Yes, all the questions that we are doing today are all previous year MCQ questions. Do not forget that this question has come at least 4 to 5 times. If you will go back home and solve previous year questions, you will know that this is a multiple time previous year MCQ. Is that clear? Any doubts? Yes, chaliye. So morphine is a potent opioid analgesic, could come in an MCQ. Any severe or persistent pain, anybody who's undergone surgery can use it. It has some side effects like nausea, vomiting, constipation, and drowsiness. Right? Which one of the following techniques is safest for the detection of any tumor? Which one is safe? This can cause tumors. That's a hint that I'm telling you. Right? Along with UV rays. So this is not safe. X-rays are not safe. Yes. What are the other ones? Is it an MRI, a CT? For histopathological study, you have to cut and take sample. Yes or no? You have to take a sample and only then can you put it under the microscope. So cutting and taking sample can also cause injury. So now you have two options. Come on, tell me anyone from the two options. Yes. MRI, right? Because it is very, very good to do imaging. correct? Histopathological studies, that means the taking of the specimen is invasive. Radiographs, that means x-rays, and CT, computed tomography, involves x-rays which are harmful. In MRI, there are only strong magnetic fields and non-ionizing radiations. Ionizing radiations can cause DNA change, right? Ionizing radiation can cause DNA change. MRI has non-ionizing radiations. Is that clear? Right? So they are the least harmful. Clear? Where will you look now? In yesterday's class, on a lot of public demand, I had shared all the links of the YouTube videos. Yes or no? Did you find time to go back home and see them in yesterday's class? I had shared the class which I took at 12 o'clock, 12 to 1. I had shared all the links. I had taken a complete webinar only on malaria. That means it was like a 40 to 45 minute class only on malaria. One question from this is going to come 100%. Is that clear? So please go back home and see the webinar. You have any doubts, I will do it. The bonus lectures are also getting ready. You have any doubts, you tell me. Done? Should I move ahead? So where will you look for the sporozoites of the malarial parasite? Aapko sporozoites kaha mein? Sporozoites are, let me give you a hint, they are injected in humans. So jo cheez humans mein inject ho rahi hai, usko sporozoites kehte hai. Agar kisi human ko sporozoite mil gaya, that means that human being can develop malaria. Is that clear? Are you smiling? Are you understanding? Everybody is super cool, right? So sporozoites are the ones which enter the human and cause infections. So human ko mosquito kar raha hai bite. Bite karne pe taki human ka blood clot na ho, so that the human blood does not clot, the malaria will secrete its saliva, and the saliva of the malaria has sporozoites. So tell me the answer now. Yes. So where are the sporozoites? The sporozoites are basically found in the salivary gland of mosquito. Where are they found? They are found, let me write it for you, they are found in the salivary gland of the mosquito. Saliva of infected female Anopheles mosquito mein sporozoites hote hai. Is that clear? And they are injected in humans. They are injected in. So sporozoids seedha jayenge kaha? They will go to the liver of the humans to further cause the infection. Done? Right? So sporozoids represent the infective stage of malarial parasite because this enters the human and causes infection. So this can come in an MCQ question. Look at the theory which I'm doing, which I'm pasting after every question, very important. So a healthy person will only get malaria when a female Anopheles mosquito. Why does female suck blood? Because the female has to lay eggs. The male does not have to lay eggs, so therefore the male does not suck blood. The female requires extra energy. So jab female Anopheles sporozoites wala saliva kisi human ko degi, to us proboscis is the sucker. See. And look at this photo. See how that sucker has gone down. Look at the photo carefully. Come on, everybody. Can you see that? Right? So, wo kya karegi? Apne salivary gland se, it is going to add sporozoids. Right? Aur salivary gland se kyun suck karegi? Kyunki salivary gland mein kya hota hai? What is present in the salivary gland? Anticoagulant. Otherwise, so human being ka blood kya ho jayega? Clot ho jayega. So that it wants to have some blood. So it is going to secrete anticoagulant saliva. Saliva mein thousands of sporozoites she will add the moment she comes and bites, right? Which one of the following acts as a physiological barrier? It's not a physical barrier. Don't get confused. It's a physiological barrier. That means it's a living barrier. There is some cell element. Physical barrier is your skin. There is no living element to it. Which one of them is a physiological, is a living barrier to the entry of microorganisms in the human body? Come on. Yes, correct. Well answered. Very, very well answered. It has to be tears because tears contain lysozyme. And the lysozyme has the ability to destroy, correct everybody, the cell wall. The cell wall can be destroyed by lysozyme. Is that clear? So lysozyme destroys the cell wall. Physiological barriers include acid in the stomach, very important. Saliva in the mouth because that also contains lysozyme. Tears from the eyes all prevent microbial growth. Lysozyme is found in good quantity in tears. They attack bacteria and dissolve their cell wall. I have two extra questions for you now. Two extra questions, my favorite student of the day question number one. Ready? What is a cell wall deficient bacteria called? Come on my screen. What is a bacteria which does not have a cell wall called? L forms. Cell wall deficient bacteria is called L forms. It's a multiple time AIIMS MCQ. Multiple time AIIMS MCQ. So they are known as L forms. Done? Cool. Number two question. Name the antibody which is present in tears. Name the antibody. Antibodies are made up of gamma globulins. What are the antibodies which are present in tears? It is nothing but IgA. So IgA is known as secretory antibody, right? Which is present in tears, in saliva. Any doubts? Copy that down. So lysozyme is the one which destroys the cell wall. It makes bacteria without cell walls. Any doubt in the class, please? Anything that you've not understood till this question? Yes, perfect. Let's move ahead. Chaliye. Next question on your screen. Select the correct statement with respect to diseases and immunization. Immunization is either vaccines or antibody formation. Chaliye. Correct statement with respect to diseases and immunization. Done? Excellent. Well answered. Let me start from the wrong answers, right? If injection of snake antivenom, kisi ko snake ne kaat liya, aap usko fatafat hospital mein le gaye aur aapne antivenom inject kar diya. Active hota hai jab body self immunity banaye, jab body khud kaam kar rahi hai antibody banane mein, then it is called as active. Yahan to aapne bahar jaake usko inject kiya antivenom. So this is passive. Your body is not working. You are injecting antivenom. This is passive, right? Point number one, it's wrong, it's passive. Certain protozoans have been used in mass production of hepatitis B vaccine. No, hepatitis B vaccine is made with the help of E. coli in the laboratory. Therefore, see how beautiful this is. Hepatitis B vaccine ka naam hai Engerix B. It is made by E. coli, by genetic engineering. It is Engerix B. Injection of dead or inactivated pathogens can cause passive immunity. Right? No injection of dead or inactive, and it's known as vaccination. Agar aap kisi ki body mein dead ya inactive pathogens dalenge, that is vaccination. Aur agar maan lijiye ye human hai, right? Isko smile karwa dete hai, iski body mein aapne dead antigen dal diya, to ye badle mein kya banayega? Antibody. That is not passive. Antibody banana is called as active immunity. Although it is artificial active. Natural active jab disease ho jaye, artificial active immunization ke baad. Understood? If due to some reason B and T lymphocyte dono hi kaam nahi kar rahe, the body will not produce antibodies against the pathogen, because B lymphocyte hi antibody produce karte hain aur helper T cells hote hain jo inko antibody produce karne mein madad karte hain. So B lymphocyte antibody banate hain aur helper T cell inki antibody produce karne mein madad karte hain. So na B lymphocyte hai na helper T lymphocyte hai, the person will not be able to make any antibodies. Is that clear? Any doubts? Super cool. Super duper cool. Chaliye. Let's move ahead. Right? So lymphocytes produce immunity. There is B lymphocyte. There are T lymphocytes. B lymphocyte immunity banate hai. Antibody mediated immunity kehlati. It's also known as humoral immunity, antibody banana. T lymphocyte, it's known as cell mediated immunity. So T lymphocyte ko hum kehte hai CMI. Antibody formation by B cells. It's stimulated by T cells or helper T cells. Any doubts? So if the B and T lymphocytes kaam nahi karenge, antibody nahi banegi, because antibody banayega kaun? B lymphocyte. Unki help kaun karega? Helper T cell will help the B lymphocyte. MHC is major histocompatibility complex. Ye self aur kisi foreign body, that is non-self, mein body ko help karta hai. What is self? Hamari khud ki body kya hai? Aur koi non-self, koi bahar ki cheez kya hai? Who will decide it? MHC, right? Aur agar body self ko hi, khud ko hi attack karne lag jaye, that is called as autoimmune. So all these things should be crystal clear to you. Done? I want everybody smiling in today's class. Yes, easy chapter, important chapter, and the most important thing, it's a very interesting chapter because this is what you basically will study in the next 4 or 5 years. Widal test. Widal test is a test to find out क्या वो आदमी मलेरिया से सफर कर रहा है, डायबिटीज से, एचआईवी से या टाइफॉइड से. यस, एचआईवी का टेस्ट कहलाता है एलिजा, राइट? इट्स आल्सो नोन एज वेस्टर्न ब्लॉट कंफर्मेटरी टेस्ट, राइट? दिस इज बेसिकली हेमेटोलॉजिकल टेस्ट थ्रू इन्वेस्टिगेशंस ऑफ द ब्लड. सो हेमेटोलॉजिकल टेस्ट, राइट? दिस इज ग्लूकोज टेस्ट, fasting, postprandial. Widal test is used for typhoid. Is that clear? So the test for typhoid diagnosis, which is caused by Salmonella typhi, is nothing but Widal test. Can anybody tell me the vaccine for typhoid? What is the vaccine for typhoid? The name of the vaccine is TAB. Typhoid, paratyphoid A and B is the name of the vaccine. Widal test is to find out about typhoid. The name of the vaccine for typhoid is typhoid, paratyphoid A and B. Widal test was developed by the scientist by the name of GFI Widal. It's an agglutination test. That means antigen or antibody. See, can you see the dots? Can you see the dots? This is the same thing. Agglutination test ka ek aur example bataiye. How much extra information are we doing in 1 hour? Agglutination test ka ek aur naam hai ABO, blood group system wala test. Yes, where also jahan pe bhi antigen antibody ka test hoga, it has to be an agglutination test. Who discovered ABO blood group system on my screen? Come on. It was discovered by scientists by the name of Karl Landsteiner. Yes, right? So it is for the presence of antibodies against the Salmonella organisms that cause typhoid. It is used to diagnose the presence of disease in a patient. I have a question for everybody here. In your NCRT, there is a woman's name which is given who spread typhoid to a lot of people. Ek aurat thi jiski jo bahut jagah khana banati thi, jisne bahut gharon mein typhoid phaila diya. Name it. Yes. Yes, Typhoid Mary, also known as Mary Mellon. Correct? Any doubts? So this is your typhoid. Can you also see the flagella in the typhoid? Yes. And can you also, it's also a bacillus. It's a rod-shaped bacteria. Next question on your screen, please. Which one of the following is not? So many of you, itni baar batane pe, not nahi padhoge. Is a property padh loge excitement mein. Aur galat answer karke aa jaoge. Yes, don't do that. Please read not. Which one of the following is not a property of cancerous cells, whereas the remaining three are? Let me tell you something here. Just wait for a second. I'll come back to the options. Let me tell you. The most important property of a cancerous cell is spread. It spreads. This spread has a specific word, right? That word is called as metastasis. It spreads, right? Now, other cells mein kya hota hai? Other cells mein, suppose this is one cell, this is another cell. Ya main thoda pehle aise banati hu, right? This is one cell aur yahan pe dusra cell grow kar raha hai. So, ye grow kar raha hai. ये थोड़ा सा और ग्रो किया, ये और ग्रो किया. सो कैन यू सी यहां पे ग्रो करते करते ये एक दूसरे के पास आ गए. सो वेर एवर दे टच ईच अदर, दे स्टॉप ग्रोइंग बिकॉज देर इज नो स्पेस. सो जहां पे भी नंबर वन दे टच ईच अदर, दे स्टॉप ग्रोइंग. टच पे स्टॉप ग्रोइंग करना इज नोन एज कॉन्टैक्ट, मतलब जहां उनका कॉन्टैक्ट हुआ दे विल स्टॉप ग्रोइंग, विच इज नोन एज कॉन्टैक्ट इनहिबिशन. करेक्ट? But in tumors, this does not happen. Even when they are touching, they will continue to grow. So, cancer has no contact inhibition. Is that clear? And जहां पे वो बहुत grow करेंगे, they will form new blood vessels. अपने को energy देने के लिए they will form new blood vessels. What is the formation of new blood vessels on my screen? Yes, absolutely. It's known as, good, well answered there. It's known as angiogenesis. Yes, cool, understood, perfect. So now let's come back to the question. Which one of the following day is not? Understood, is not. They show contact inhibition? No, they don't. Yes, they divide an uncontrolled property. They remain confined in the area of formation. No, they show contact inhibition. No, they don't show contact inhibition at all. In fact, they keep on growing. Contact inhibition is a property of normal cells by which when they contact each other, they stop. But these cells they lack this particular property. Any doubts? Any doubts? Perfect, perfect, perfect. And beech mein kya kar rahe hain? They do angiogenesis of blood vessels. Cirrhosis of liver is a disease of liver. Liver is a very important organ. Not only is it one of the largest organs of the body after skin, it's the seat of detoxification. Right, it is the seat of detoxification. Body mein bahut detoxification yahan hota hai. It is a very, very important organ because it does a lot of regeneration. Yes, but those people who have chronic intake of alcohol every single day. So alcohol jab zyada ho jata hai, the first stage is a fatty liver. Because aap sabko pata hai, fat metabolism, glucose to glycogen, jisko maine itni baar bola hai, glycogenesis. Glucose to glycogen, extra information, please pay attention. So fatty liver is the first stage of alcohol. And the second stage is, you're absolutely right, everybody. The second stage is cirrhosis, where it shrinks. So in cirrhosis, it shrinks and it becomes a very hard structure. That is the reason of, or that is the side effect of chronic alcohol. Understood? Understood. Cirrhosis is a condition in which the liver responds to injury or death of some of its cells by producing interlacing strands of fibrous tissue. Fibrous tissue kya hoga? Right? Look at this. See? Can you see this? See, this is normal. This can be stage one of the fatty liver, and this is cirrhosis. It becomes knobbly. Nodules. The nodules are fibrous. So they're going to be very, very understood. It's like a classical thing of alcoholism. Any doubts? Again, I want stars in your eyes. I want the dreams shining in your eyes. I want the stars shining in your eyes. Any doubts? Anything that anybody hasn't understood can ask me right now. Yes? Cool. Moving ahead. Oh, this is directly from NCRT. You see in your NCRT chapter, in this particular chapter, there are structures which are given. Yes, so this chart, and this is directly an NCRT question. That is why I always say that. That is how important it is to read your NCRTs. I hope you've read your NCRTs in detail. I was thinking of doing a series on NCRT. Would you all be interested? Would you want me to do that? Yes, I'm sure. I'm doing that. We will come up with that. So identify the molecules A and B shown below and select the right option, giving their source as well as their use. What is A? What is B? What is the source and what is the use of it? Come on. Correct. Well answered. Well answered. You are answering well, everybody, today. Yes. So it is A is morphine. Papaver somniferum se liya jata. This I have told you. It's a sedative and painkiller, especially after surgeries. Right? So it's a sedative and it's a painkiller after the surgeries. The given chemical structures A and B are of morphine and cannabinoid. Yes. So morphine or cannabinoid ke structures hai. Morphine ek opium se nikala gaya. I told you, this is the beautiful poppy flower, right? So morphine decreases respiratory center. It decreases blood pressure. It is very effective because it's a neend aa jati aur pain chali jati hai. It's used after surgeries. Cannabis, sativa family, cannabis, right? They affect the cardiovascular system of the body. Cannabis is liya jata hai. Cannabis. It, both of them are basically principal drugs. Right? Okay? Chaliye. Moving ahead. Ascaris causes an infection which is known as ascariasis. Roundworm infection called ascariasis. So how is ascariasis caused? How does it spread? How is it caused? Is it caused by CC fly? CC fly, which is also known as phlebotomas, is very common in the plains of Africa. It causes a disease which is known as Trypanosoma gambionese or African sleeping sickness. Right? Write this down. Extra information. It causes a disease by the name of African sleeping sickness or Trypanosoma gambionese. CC fly is also known as phlebotomas. Yes? Eating imperfectly cooked pork can give you a disease by the name of Taenia solium or tapeworm. Taenia saginata can be caused by eating improperly cooked beef. Malaria or a mosquito bite could give us, yes, that we've just been discussing since morning. So this is caused by, look at the word that I'm writing, it's caused by fecal-oral route. That means there could be somebody who has not washed his hand properly and given you food or water, or the water pipe could be contaminated by fecal matter, right? If somebody is drinking from a hand pump, it could be contaminated by fecal matter. So drinking water containing the eggs of Ascaris is the commonest cause of having Ascariasis, which is nothing but roundworm. The complete name is Ascaris lumbricoides. It is, yes, Ascaris lumbricoides. It is dimorphic. The Ascaris male and female worms look different. Man acquires Ascaris directly by eating the eggs. They are present in improperly stored water if it is contaminated. So contaminated food and water can give you. This is a very, very important term which I'm using. It is monogenetic. That means it has only one host, right? If you look at this Taenia solium, Taenia saginata, they have two hosts. One of them is a pig or a cattle. African sleeping sickness has another host called CC fly. Plasmodium has a host called mosquito, which is a primary host, a human. But this has a single host. This year, the question can come modified as this. It's a single host. So what is a single host? Ascaris lumbricoides. Correct, roundworm. Next question on your screen, please. At which stage of HIV infection does one usually have symptoms? There are so many people, you know, what we know about HIV/AIDS is only the tip of the iceberg. That is why it's a very serious disease. Because so many people, see, there's so much of stigma which is associated with HIV, ki agar kisi ko ye hoti hai, koi batata hi nahi hai. That, you know, those people are suffering from HIV. Are you getting my point, everybody? Are you understanding? So we know only this. And iske symptoms ka pata hi nahi chalta hai. Iske jo general symptoms hote hai na, wo hote hai fever, weight loss. Yes, badan dard. I will call that malaise. And puri body mein jo lymph nodes hain, wo kya kar jate hain? Swell ho jate. तो इसमें ऐसा कुछ दिखाई नहीं देता है कि किसी को बहुत पता चले. व्हाट इज द स्टेज जब पूरे के पूरे सिम्टम्स दिखाई देने लग जाते हैं, सिम्टम्स ऑफ एड्स दिखाई देने लग जाते हैं. यस, व्हाट इज द आंसर? व्हेन एचआईवी डैमेजेस लार्ज नंबर ऑफ टी लिम्फोसाइट्स, राइट? सो देयर आर स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ टी लिम्फोसाइट्स व्हिच आर नोन एज CD4 सेल्स. हमारी बॉडी में टी लिम्फोसाइट सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी करवाते हैं. कौन सी इम्यूनिटी? CMI, सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी. टी लिम्फोसाइट्स एक स्पेशल तरह के होते हैं हमारी बॉडी में. उनका नाम होता है CD4, क्लस्टर ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन 4. राइट दिस डाउन. इट्स अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ टी लिम्फोसाइट्स. जब CD4 सेल का नंबर 200 से भी कम हो जाए, when the number of CD4 cells becomes less than 200, that is the time that the person has HIV and we call it कि इस पर्सन को अब क्या हो गया है, AIDS, right? तो AIDS कब कहेंगे? जब CD4 cells का number 200 से भी कम हो जाए. उससे पहले क्या कहेंगे? CD4 जब तक 200 से ज्यादा रहेंगे, T lymphocytes ज्यादा रहेंगे, we will call it HIV positive. When it will become less than CD4, will become less than 200, we will call it HIV. It's high five. Done. Super cool. Any doubts till now? Giving you a doubt window. Any doubts till now? Anything that you've not understood till now? Are you understanding? It's an easy, important chapter. Yes, don't miss on this chapter. It's a very important chapter. AIDS is a disorder of the cell-mediated immune system, right? Virus responsible is a retrovirus, HIV, because it contains RNA. Ye T lymphocytes ko affect karta hai. जो बी लिम्फोसाइट्स को एंटीबॉडी को प्रोड्यूस नहीं होने देते, बिकॉज यू नो टी हेल्पर टी सेल ही एंटीबॉडी बनाएंगे. तो अगर हेल्पर टी सेल नहीं होगा, बॉडी में एंटीबॉडी नहीं बनेगी. बिकॉज द हेल्पर टी सेल में अगर एंटीबॉडी नहीं बनेगी, ऑब्वियसली बॉडी की इम्यूनिटी क्या कर जाएगी? क्रैश. करेक्ट. मूविंग अहेड, द एक्टिव फॉर्म ऑफ एंट अबीबा हिस्टोलिटिका. लेट मी फर्स्ट ब्रेक दिस डाउन फॉर यू, देन यू विल योर सेल्फ आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. लेट मी जस्ट गिव यू अ सेकंड, आई ब्रेक इट डाउन फॉर यू. एंट वर्ड इज टेकन फ्रॉम द वर्ड एंटेरिक, विच यू मस्ट रिमेंबर, विच स्टार्ट्स फॉर इंटेस्टाइन. सो एंटेराइटिस इज इन्फ्लेमेशन ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन. अमीबा, बिकॉज इट लुक्स लाइक दिस, इट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ सूडोपोडिया. सो दिस इज अमीबा. हिस्टो का मतलब होता है टिश्यू. लाइटिका का मतलब होता है डिस्ट्रक्शन. So it destroys the tissue. मान लीजिए, just pay attention now. मान लीजिए किसी की intestine है. So entamoeba histolytica क्या करेगा? Intestine में hole कर देगा. Intestine को destroy कर देगा. ऐसे होल कर दिया उसके इंटेस्टाइन में, अब इस होल से निकल के बाहर चला जाएगा। सो जब वो इंटेस्टाइन को डिस्ट्रॉय करेगा, एंटमीबा हिस्टोलिटिका, जब एंटमीबा हिस्टोलिटिका पहला काम क्या करेगा, इंटेस्टाइन को डिस्ट्रॉय। जब वो इंटेस्टाइन को डिस्ट्रॉय करेगा, क्या वो साथ में आरबीसीज को डिस्ट्रॉय करेगा जो इंटेस्टाइन की लाइनिंग में होंगे? यस। तो क्या उसकी वजह से ब्लीडिंग होगी? यस। तो अब ये ब्लड में चला गया इंटेस्टाइन को डिस्ट्रॉय करके, ब्लड से ये पहुंच जाएगा लिवर में। सो एंटमीबा हिस्टोलिटिका में बहुत कॉमनली लिवर में भी एब्सेस देखे जाते हैं, अमीबिक लिवर एब्सेसेस, दे आर नोन एज अमीबिक लिवर एब्सेसेस। तो आप मुझे बताइए एक्टिव फॉर्म ऑफ एंटमीबा हिस्टोलिटिका क्या क्या करेगा? खाना खाएगा इंटेस्टाइन में, ब्लड खाएगा, इरिथ्रोसाइट, म्यूकोसा, सब म्यूकोसा, कोलॉन, सब में छेद करके आगे जाएगा, या सिर्फ म्यूकोसा और सब म्यूकोसा जाएगा? बताइए, दिख रहा है आपको? मैंने आरबीसीज को भी डिस्ट्रॉय करवाया है। सो आंसर क्या होगा? यस, एक चीज मैं आपको और बता देती हूँ। नॉर्मल मान लीजिए डाइसेंट्री है, नॉर्मल डाइसेंट्री जो हो सकती है वो विब्रियो कॉलेरा की वजह से हो सकती है, वो टाइफाइड की वजह से हो सकती है, उसमें सिर्फ स्टूल्स आएंगे। बट एंड अमीबा हिस्टोलिटिका में ब्लड भी आएगा एंड स्टूल्स भी आएंगे। दिस इज द डिफरेंस जिसकी वजह से हम बहुत इजीली एंटमीबा हिस्टोलिटिका डायग्नोज कर सकते हैं। इज दैट क्लियर? दिस विल हैव, लेट मी राइट इट डाउन हियर, अंडरस्टैंडिंग, दिस इज द मोस्ट करेक्टरिस्टिक डिफरेंस विच इज सीन। डन, मूविंग अहेड, द एक्टिव फॉर्म ऑफ एंटमीबा हिस्टोलिटिका फीड्स ऑन इरिथ्रोसाइट्स व्हिच आर आरबीसीज, द म्यूकोसा एंड सब म्यूकोसा ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन दैट इज कोलोन, वेयर इट विल मेक अ होल एंड इट विल गो ऑल द वे अप टू द लिवर। सो इट्स अ नाइस ट्रिकी क्वेश्चन, बट इफ यू नो द डिजीज, द बॉटम लाइन इज इफ यू नो द थियोरी, इफ यू नो द डिजीज, यू विल बी एबल टू आंसर इट। यस। So, Entamoeba histolytica is the causative organism of amoebic dysentery or amoebiasis. It's present in the large intestine. यहाँ से ये liver में चला जाता है, वहां से, see, once it enters the blood, एक बार ये ब्लड में गया, वहां से वो लिवर में भी जा सकता है, वो लंग्स में भी जा सकता है, कहीं भी जा सकता है। बट द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, वो लिवर में जाएगा बिकॉज लिवर ऑल्सो इज अ रिच सप्लाई ऑफ ब्लड। अंडरस्टूड? इसके तीन फॉर्म्स होते हैं, दिस कैन कम इन योर एम्स एग्जाम, दिस कैन कम इन योर नीट एग्जाम। पहला फॉर्म होगा ट्रोफोजोइट फॉर्म और मैग्ना फॉर्म, फिर ये सिस्ट बनाता है, सिस्ट बनाने से पहले वाला प्रीसिस्टिक, और लास्ट में स्टूल्स में, जिसको भी एंटमीबा हिस्टोलिटिका है उसके स्टूल्स में सिस्ट रिलीज होगी। क्या रिलीज होगी? सिस्ट। एमसीक्यू में बहुत बार आया हूं, स्पेशली व्हेन दे वांट टू मेक द एमसीक्यू टफ, प्लीज पे अटेंशन, दिस इज द थ्योरी दैट यू ऑल आस्क फॉर। द ट्रोफोजोइट इज द मोस्ट एक्टिव फॉर्म। सो अगर ह्यूमंस को इन्फेक्शन होनी है, ह्यूमंस क्या खाना चाहिए डाइट में इन्फेक्शन के लिए? ह्यूमंस विल बी पैथोजेनिक फॉर्म। कौन है जो ह्यूमंस में डिजीज कॉज कर सकता है? ट्रोफो जोइड। और स्टूल्स में क्या रिलीज होता है? सिस्टिक फॉर्म्स। डन, लेट्स मूव अहेड। इफ यू सस्पेक्ट मेजर डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ एंटीबॉडीज, आपको लग रहा है कि किसी आदमी की बॉडी में एंटीबॉडी नहीं बन रही है, विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वुड बी अ कंफर्मेटरी एविडेंस? एंटीबॉडीज किसकी बनती है? लुक एट द एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम इन नीट क्लासेस विच आई टेकन। एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम पे मैंने नीट के यूट्यूब वीडियोस डाले हैं, किडनी के यूट्यूब वीडियोस डाले हैं मैंने, यू रिमेम्बर देम? यस। तो एंटीबॉडीज किसकी बनती है? एंटीबॉडी बनती है, इज इट द एल्ब्यूमिन, हीमोसाइट्स, फाइब्रिनोजन और सीरम? हीमोसाइट्स आर ब्लड सेल्स, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन एवरीथिंग टू यू फास्ट। सो बीट आरबीसी, बीट डब्ल्यूबीसी, बीट प्लेटलेट्स, राइट? फाइब्रिनोजन कन्वर्ट्स टू फाइब्रिन एंड फाइब्रिन विल फॉर्म द क्लॉट। सो फाइब्रिनोजन टू फिब्रिन कौन कन्वर्ट करता है? फाइब्रिनोजन टू फिब्रिन कन्वर्ट होता है अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ थ्रोम्बिन, राइट? सो फाइब्रिनोजन, फाइब्रिन, थ्रोम्बिन, ये सब क्या है? दे आर ऑल क्लॉटिंग फैक्टर्स। व्हाट आर दे? क्लॉटिंग फैक्टर्स। एल्ब्यूमिन विल बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द ब्लड वॉल्यूम। एल्ब्यूमिन इज अ, यस, इज अ सॉल्यूट। मैंने कितनी बार आपको बताया, व्हाट डज द सॉल्यूट अट्रैक्ट? सॉल्वेंट। सो सॉल्यूट, सॉल्वेंट की वॉल्यूम, द ब्लड का वॉल्यूम, हु कंट्रोल्स द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द ब्लड? एल्ब्यूमिन। अंडरस्टूड? ग्लोबुलिन को हम गामा ग्लोबुलिन भी कहते हैं। सो मच ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा इंफॉर्मेशन इन वन स्लाइड। Gamma globulins are the ones which make antibodies. Is that clear? Antibodies are made up of proteins. So that person will definitely have a protein deficiency, but which protein specifically? That protein deficiency that that person will be having will be gamma globulins, right? They're present in the serum, so we call them serum globulins. Any doubts? Right? Serum globulins are proteins. Dekhi, gamma globulins. Dekhi ye word. Very, very important. They're known as antibodies, right? So there are two proteins in the blood. Number one protein of the blood is albumin, jo blood ka volume maintain karta hai. Aur number two protein hota hai globulin, jo body ki immunity ko maintain karke rakhta hai. Is that clear? So alpha 1 globulin, alpha 2 globulin, beta globulin, gamma globulin. Gamma globulin is the most important because gamma globulin makes antibodies. So basically, jaise main aapko bata rahi thi, deficiency to protein ki hi hogi. Protein zyada dena padega. But kaun sa specific type ka protein hoga? It will be gamma globulin. Any doubts? Anybody who hasn't understood anything till now? Yes, let's move ahead. Which one of the following disease is caused by a protozoa? Which one of the following is caused by protozoa? Bataiye. Ye toh humne aaj dekha hai, common cold, influenza. Yes. Viral. It is. Which one of the following disease is caused by protozoa? Yes. Is that clear? Right? Now see. Dhyan se suniye. Correct. Listen to me. So yeah. Which one of the following diseases is caused by a protozoan? Is it babesiosis, blastomycosis or syphilis? Like I was just telling you, influenza, my dear children, influenza is caused by a virus. Syphilis is a sexually transmitted disease. Are you getting my point? What is it? It is a sexually transmitted disease. It is caused by, write this down, Treponema palladium. So it's a bacteria which is known as Treponema palladium. It is a spirochete. That means it's a spiral bacteria. Blastomycosis, wherever the word myco will come. Mycology is the study of, yes, you are right, fungus, right? Phycology is the study of plants. Mycology is the study of funguses. So wherever the word will come, blastomycosis or mycosis, we are basically dealing with funguses. So babesiosis is like a tick fever. It is basically, we used to think it is a disease of cattle. It is caused by protozoa, right? So I think I've wrongly marked this answer. This is not the answer. The answer is babesiosis. Explanation theek diya hai. Aapko pata hai iska answer kya hai. It is caused by Treponema palladium, which is nothing but a bacteria. This is fungal. This is viral. So what is the answer for this question? The answer for this question is babesiosis is a malaria-like parasitic disease caused by infection with babesia, which is a parasitic protozoan. So it is not syphilis. Syphilis is, yes, you are absolutely right. It's a sexually transmitted disease caused by Treponema palladium, which is a spirochete. Influenza is a viral disease. Mycology is fungal disease, right? So babesia red blood cells mein disease cause karti hai, mammals mein, generally animals mein hoti hai. Ye RBCs ko destroy kar deti hai. Dekhiye, main pehle iske bare mein baat kar chuki hu. Jab RBC destroy ho jayenge, obviously anemia hoga. But which type of anemia will be caused by destruction of RBCs? It will be hemolytic. That means you're destroying the RBCs, known as hemolytic anemia. Any doubt? I just told you, North America, usually it is also transmitted by ticks, which travel from, you know, animals to humans. Any doubts? This is how babesiosis, you know, the protozoa looks inside the RBCs. It destroys the RBCs. Any doubts? Anything that anybody in my class has not understood till now? Done? Moving ahead, moving ahead. In higher vertebrates, the immune system can distinguish self cells and non-cells. If this property is lost due to genetic abnormality, we've done this. Yes, that means if I attack self, correct? Agar I can't destroy, I can't differentiate between self and non-self. Right? What is it called? Graft rejection is agar kisi ko ek donor mila hai, ek organ donate hua hai, aur wo usko graft reject. This is done by T cells. Remember this. राइट एलर्जिक रिस्पॉन्स इज हिस्टामिन वाला. एक्टिव इम्यूनिटी क्या होती है? जब आप खुद एंटीबॉडीज बनाते हो, सेल्फ योर बॉडी इज मेकिंग एंटीबॉडीज. एब्सोल्युटली राइट. सो व्हाट इज योर ऑटो इम्यून डिजीज? व्हेन यू अटैक योर ओन बॉडी, दैट इज नोन एज अ ऑटो इम्यून डिजीज. व्हेन द बॉडी अटैक्स द ओन बॉडी, इट इज रेफर्ड टू एज अ ऑटो इम्यून डिजीज. वी हैव डन दैट, राइट? ऑटो इम्यूनिटी इज अ डिसऑर्डर ऑफ द बॉडीज डिफेंस mechanism. It could be known as lupus, it could be known as erythematosus, it could even be a disease like this, which is eczema, extremely extremely common. So both, I mean majority of them, are autoimmune disorders in which the body destroys its own tissues. Done? Cool? Understanding? Moving ahead, last 5 minutes, let's do 7-8 more questions and wrap up this session. Super cool. Which one of the following, mind you, there are two correct answers in this question. There are two correct answers. Which one of the following is correct regarding AIDS causative agent, HIV? So HIV is a retrovirus. It has RNA. It has antigens on its surface. It has glycoproteins on its surface. It has an envelope. It has an envelope, so it is not unenveloped. Chaliye, which one of the following is correct? I've told you that there are two correct answers. Come on. Right? So which one of the following? Yes, HIV is enveloped virus. Bilkul correct hai. It contains two identical molecules of single-stranded RNA, ssRNA ka bana hua hai. Aur beech mein hai reverse transcriptase. Right? Because RNA ka virus hota hai, iske paas reverse transcriptase enzyme hoti hai. Ye reverse transcription karega. Aur RNA se kya bana dega? DNA. Right? It does not escape but attacks the acquired immune response, right? So all the lymphocytes are destroyed. All the cells of the immune system are destroyed by the HIV. Is that clear? And when it destroys, right? It destroys. Pehle to wo unme chupke rehte, baad mein usko destroy kar deta hai immune system ko, right? So isliye body mein kya ho jati hai? Body mein decreased immunity ho jati hai. The immunity decreases. Is that clear? Right? Okay. HIV is a spherical virus. Diameter is around this much. It consists of a single-stranded RNA filament segment into two identical filaments. And dekho, single-stranded RNA hai. Aur beech mein kaun laga hota hai? Reverse transcriptase. Iske bahar protein coat hota hai. It, you know, it is a virus. Hamari body ke helper T cells ko maar deta hai ye. So without helper T cells, it destroys our immunity. It attacks the immunity. It destroys our helper T cells. Helper T cells ke bina hum antibodies nahi bana sakte. The B see helper T cell will help the B cell to make antibodies. It's a helper cell. Wo hamari body mein antibody banvayega. So if there is no helper T cell, there will be no antibody in the body, and therefore the body will be susceptible to infections, which will cause a lot of damage to the body. Done. Moving ahead. MALT and GALT. MALT is mucosa associated lymphoid tissue. Your mouth has mucosa, your inner body has mucosa. GALT is gut, that means the intestine. Gut associated, yes, lymphoid tissue. GALT lymphoid, let me write it down for you quickly so that you remember it. Gut associated lymphoid tissue is the one which is there in the intestine. The tissue which is there in the intestine to produce WBCs like Peyer cells and Paneth patches. Liver ke paas apne WBCs hote hai. Extra information, what is it? Kupffer cells. Malt is mucosa. Jitni body ka mucus surface hai. Right? So mucosa associated lymphoid tissue is nearly correct. 50% of the lymphoid tissue of the body. Malt are significant aggregation. Significant means kaafi zyada aggregations of lymphoid tissue. They are around 50% of the lymphoid tissue in the human body. 50% of the lymphoid tissue in the human body is MALT. Malarial parasites with 48-hour cycle is, right? That means 48 hours baad bukhar chadega. So 48 hours ke baad RBC destroy honge. Jab RBC destroy hote hain, so there is both shivering as well as very high fever followed by sweating. So this cycle of RBC destruction of shivering, sweating and fever is happening after 48 hours. What out of ABCD option, kaun se hai jo ye karenge? Absolutely right. It will be caused by P. falciparum, Ovalen, Vivax. falciparum also causes very important, write it down, cerebral malaria. That means malaria of the brain, which is very, very, very dangerous. Next question on your screen. राइट सो या ये मलेरियल है, ये देखिए ये इसके अंदर पूरे के पूरे बन गए हैं, मलेरियल पैरासाइट्स डिवाइड हो रहा है एंड दिस आरबीसी विल नाउ बर्स्ट. सो द बर्स्टिंग पी मलेरिया द ड्यूरेशन इज ऑफ 72 आवर्स के बाद बर्स्ट होगा. डन. एनी डाउट्स? विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन एंड फोटोग्राफ बड़ी मजेदार लगाई है मैंने ताकि आप लोगों को याद रखे. जूनोसिस आर डिजीजेस विच स्प्रेड फ्रॉम एनिमल्स. वो बीमारियां जो एनिमल्स होती है, कैटल से हो सकती है, डॉग से हो सकती है, राइट? किसी भी एनिमल से जो डिजीजेस है, राइट? लेप्रोसी? नो, लेप्रोसी इज कॉज्ड बाय माइकोबैक्टीरियम लेप्रे. डिप्थीरिया और वूपिंग कफ इसका नाम होता है, दमा वाली खांसी, बहुत जोर से खांसी आती है. दिस इज कॉज्ड बाय कॉर्नी बैक्टीरियम डिप्थीरिया. leprosy is caused by, yes, mycobacterium leprae. It is rabies. Rabies happens from, look at this photograph. Yes, rabid dogs. Zoonosis is infectious disease of animals that can be transmitted to humans. और जो animals humans में disease आएंगे zoonotic, वो diseases जो animals से humans में आ सकती है zoonosis, right? Right? So rabies, rabies में पानी से बहुत डर लगता है. This can be a direct MCQ. So that person develops hydrophobia क्योंकि ये पूरे गले में muscles contract हो जाती हैं. There is spasm. So, इसलिए कुछ खाने पीने का मन नहीं करता. दैट इज नोन एज हाइड्रोफोबिया. लास्ट क्वेश्चन. डिजीज ड्यू टू मैल फंक्शनिंग ऑफ ऑर्गन्स, ड्यू टू एज, ड्यू टू सम वीकनेस, राइट? ड्यू टू सम डेफिशिएंसी, अ ऑर्गन कैन मैल फंक्शन. सो जब भी एक ऑर्गन मैल फंक्शन करता है, व्हाट इज द डिजीज? इज इट डेफिशिएंसी और डीजेनरेशन? डीजेनरेशन. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स इट इज एज, स्पेशली योर जॉइंट्स, राइट? दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई नी जॉइंट्स, स्पेशली योर टीथ. दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई डेंचर्स आर रिक्वायर्ड, व्हाई स्पेक्स, राइट? सो डीजेनरेटिव डिजीज अकर ड्यू टू डिट्योरेशन और लॉस ऑफ स्पेशलाइज्ड फंक्शन ऑफ द ऑर्गन. इट कुड बी बिकॉज ऑफ डिफेक्टिव ब्लड सप्लाई, डिपोजिशन ऑफ कैल्शियम सॉल्ट्स. सो ये नॉर्मल डिस्क है, लुक हाउ नाइस एंड थिक, डीजेनरेटिंग डिस्क बल्ज कर गई है, राइट? पूरी की पूरी बाहर आ गई. दिस कैन बी वेरी पेनफुल, फॉर विच आइदर सर्जरी इज रिक्वायर्ड और यू नीड टू वेयर अ कॉलर बोन इफ इट्स द नेक. Right? So that, my dear children, brings us to the end of a phenomenal, phenomenal session. We come to the end of the first part of human health. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you will open the window, and that window will open only through your hard work. And I hope you will remember the promises that you've made to me. Yes? So I will see you again in another super cool session in the next class. Till then, take care. I did share all the links. If there's any other webinar that you want me to make, write it down for me. I will see you in the next class. Till then, take care, study very hard, and stay extremely calm. Bye.